Hello, just another day using SuperMemo. Today it's Saturday, August 21st of 2010. And yesterday I was kind of, not depressed, that's not the exact word, but there were some issues that I felt a little angry, and I did a shorter session because of that. So today, I hope I can at least keep using SuperMemo text-based. I will try to use pictures with the component. The goal for today is to really understand how the components works. And yeah, I will leave video for now. And what incremental writing, incremental learning, reading pops up today. Oh man, I have so many things now. Okay, so first I would like to see the outstanding topics from today, or even items. Priority queue, outstanding here. Oh my god, how many rows, how many columns. So I have, whoa, so many. So I memorized 18 items. That's outstanding items, 13 plus. I understand. Topics and final drill. And the 271, what's for this? And 5.5% proportion of outstanding items should for the final drill. More items scheduled for today. This seems low. I don't know if this it is really low or not. Okay. So responding with facts. Okay, let's keep. Email fact. For the time being, I don't plan to use email with incremental email, so we'll dismiss this. Maybe in the future tab I might be using, and I want to dismiss all the shortcuts because I'm going to generate them with an external XML file. A higher level role is minimum work for maximum knowledge. Memory effect. What? Auto-sort repetitions that results in sorting your na-na-na by priority queue. I don't want that. No. Okay. Outstanding queue. Oh my god, it's what I just saw, what I just looked. What's that sound for? Let me go to the settings. I recall a setting that was for sound feedback. None. Thank you. Now the knowledge tree have disappeared. Alt C. Thank you. So if a note is used as a container for other notes, it may be called a folder. Yep. overload the course when the student has more items, outstanding items or topics. Yeah. If a node has children, it's called a branch. Yep. Use the nanana to list critical topics and items. If you study it, a picture. Use the picture. I will rephrase this as use a picture. And nanana is a single page of information. Topic, element. Okay. For topics on task, a factor is interpreted as the number of which the current interval should be multiplied to get the value of the next interval. Concept maps forms a skeleton for the nanana, which analyzes neural review. Sprint activation, bro, I keep forgetting this. Let me check that again. I know I have imported this. What? Has opened inside the element? Okay. This is a new form of semantic review in SuperMemo. Wow, that's way too advanced for me. So, let me postpone this card. Not the interval. No. Well, moving on. Excuse me. A node is one element. The knowledge tree presented in the contents window. Yeah, that's incremental writing. Incremental learning manual. You can process email incrementally in SuperMemo. Yep. The pros and cons. That will be useful to know. Advantages. Recall of important facts, prioritization, and handling overflow. So first, I have several email accounts. I think I have like 12 accounts overall. But I don't have overflow for my personal messages, emails. So I also don't need prioritization because I only get a few each day. And recall, you can make an extract of emails. Yeah. With my current email, I don't need to be incremental. I don't get benefit of this. It's just so few emails with very little room of learning. So for the time being, I will dismiss this. Cognitive experimentals of theory. Oh man, I will put my phone because the heat is killing me. I know if you can tell I'm sweating all. Back. Okay, it's in the lowest setting. I hope it doesn't. It's not hurting the microphone. So, heuristics, through a greater refinement and research, have begun to apply to other theories or explained by them. For example, the cognitive experiential self theory also has an adaptive view of heuristic processing. Yeah. A part of the experimental process is often adaptive, but vulnerable to error. Yeah. Through greater refinement and research have begun to apply to. Yeah, that's all I need. And by doing so, I am so out of context. No, that's not what I want. I want to go to the parent. It's not Alt up, Control up. I don't know. Alt C. Oh, tachycromatal writing for myself. Alt D. And Alt D. Moving on. Attribute substitution. In 2002, Daniel Kelman and Shane Frederick proposed to cognitive heuristics works by a process called attribute substitution, which happened without conscious awareness. Attribute substitution. Or substitution bias. Okay, attribute substitution. And that was a... I don't recall where I was. Heuristic attribute substitution. Well, I will leave it here. I'm going to move on. I don't know. So according to this theory, when somebody makes a judgment that is computationally complex or rather easily calculated, a heuristic attribute is substituted. In effect, a cognitively difficult problem is dealt with by answering a rather simple problem without being aware of this happening. This theory explains cases where judgments fail to show regression reward to mean. Heuristics can be considered to reduce the complexity of clinical judgment in healthcare. Okay. Escape. Yeah. Shift. Click. Regression towards the mean. Wow. Oh, that's the picture. I know that SuperMemo doesn't support LaTeX, and their SuperMemo system for that, which I still haven't tried. Okay, let me import this. Close the browser, and incremental learning. Okay, let me change the default. Nah, it's not this. That's what I wanted. Okay. Yeah, it's all gibberish. I closed the window. Okay, let me put that. After other possibilities like math not Jax. Let me check this. Anki math for more. I know there are a couple of latex mud jacks. Okay. And keep memo. So mud jacks. Latex. Okay, my jacks, that's it. So we'll like to try both. If one doesn't work, I can try the other one. But that's not a priority. Moving on. According to this theory, when someone makes judgment, this could be all complexes. Okay, did I import this already? Regression reverse the mean? Yep. What I just did? Why it's empty? Ctrl-Alt-C. This one screen is going to show. So, attribute substitution explains cases where the judgment failed to show regression towards the mean. And I will change the priority because I will need to read the other article. Nope. Oh, it's super low. Yeah, that will work. Moving on. Representativeness heuristic, a mental shortcut used when making judgments about the probability of an event under certainty, or judging a situation based on how familiar the prospects are to the prototypes that person holds in his or her mind. Okay. Participants were a description of a woman named Linda. Based on the description, it was likely that Linda was a feminist. 80 to 90% of the participants, choosing from two options, choose that was most likely for Linda to be a feminist. And bank teller that only a bank Teller. I don't get that. The likelihood of two events cannot be greater than of either of the two element events individually. For this reason, the representativeness heuristic is exemplary of conjunction fallacy. Not to be confused with false conjunction. Okay, I will export them both. Import. Okay, moving on. The heuristic representativeness heuristic is an exemplary of what fallacy? This one. Okay. Task Link Manager Toolbar. Here's the most important controls on the task list. So it was F4. Okay, let me. Today I wanted to try the shopping list. So to get familiar with the tag list. Yeah, I do remember this. Okay, task list combo box tab. Okay. I don't have any other tag list. So I guess is this. Are we rotating this? I guess. Set the current task list as the default one. I only have one, that will be the default already. Menu. Task list manager menu. Dismiss task. Edit parameters, add task, transfer. Alt F1. Oh, so many shortcuts, bro. Okay, view, control, enter. I still don't get why the description is like this. If you are edit this, how do I edit? View? Look at the description. It's not description, it's this. I still don't get. Nowhere says description. Tag list. Where can I see this text? Alt-C. Is this task? That's the title. Nope. F4. Description, I want to generate. And what's hello where? I don't get this. Where's the hello where can I see this text? Why is it not doesn't appear in here? Not the comment. Not the task description. I really don't get it. Okay, let me create a new one. Group tasks template. task. Test. Tag list, the same description. Test to description. Cool. Okay. So now this description is matching the text here. So if I modify this, adding extra text. What the f- So the task definition is the same, but why is not here? I don't get this. The description, I want to generate a topic, why it's not here? And it's another text, is what I don't get. Group, task, template, task, is the same. Element type, task. And the other one. Task, task, and task. It's exactly the same. And task list, tags. Tasks. It's exactly the same. I don't get why the description is different. It's still here. F4. Another description is blank here. They should be the same. So let me test this. Test number two. I will do the description here. Okay. And it becomes empty here. If I add it back, it goes back as expected. And what if I delete the text here? F4. The description, it's still there. Now, if I change this to different text, now I go to the tasks. Here you go. I now understand the issue here. So I think that's one of the limitations of SuperMemo, as far as I know. So you have to edit the description here, not inside the card, inside the element. Or all edits I do won't be retroactively affected in here. Okay. Finally, I solved this. The writing help. Do I do that? I don't understand that. I don't see it. What I haven't done? I will put it here. Topic. That will be tasks. So, in SuperMemo at least 18, task. Description should be edited, modified inside the task window, F4, etc., and not from the very card. item card itself order wise that changes won't be updated retroactively. Cool. Okay, I was here. Go to add task, delete task, find task, short, sort task by priority. Oh, let me see the priority. Max. Priority, yeah. Okay, now the shortcut for priority, what was that? Control S. Is this descendant? Oh, it's the same sort. Yeah. Gotcha. I can export as an HTML file. Cool. Okay. Okay, this is expected. SuperMemo for Windows build 18.42. It's HP. The charge set is not using Unicode. I guess once I import my text from Anki, having Japanese or Korean, I get that will be getting issues. Okay, I can dismiss this. Sunk cost. Okay, now let's see. I want to move this picture, well, this which is higher resolution. Copy and shift insert. Oops, but I want the picture to be as a component. So, in this case, I forgot how to do it. SuperMemo. Oh, that's an old version. Control P, that's what I did. Oh, maybe I have to be outside of the editing mode, right? Sh- Shift insert. It's doing nothing. Copy. Nope, doing nothing. And I'm inside, it will copy inside the text. Shift insert. Yep. And if this inter-registry, oh, those are the extractions I did for testing the head, and yeah, I don't need those. So what I don't get is the color. What's the yellow for and the orange? Okay, let me take that. I don't understand that. Topic. Image. Registry. Color. Highlight. Color. What is yellow for? Yellow and orange. Okay. No, it's not in the registry. So then the question is, what is this picture? Okay, if you want to see the HTML, playing, switching presentation mode, switching reading mode. Nope, that was not helpful. HTML format interpreted as in Internet Explorer. What's that? That's not what I needed. Yes. Create an image component. Okay, so now how I do delete this? I don't want this component now. Delete component? Yes. So what I need is to modify the template. That's not an elliptic shape. That's just a component shape. First, I'm clicking here and the menu appears there. I really don't understand this. One HTML. Okay, so moving on, I failed to put the picture as a component. So now we will try. Fit picture, fit the component. Pass. HTML, parse article. Template, apply, detach, or impose. I will need to learn the difference here. This. Well, I will delete this once I'm done with reading the article. And to see also, yeah, I can get it like this. Cool. Then let me do the, where it is. What's happening? Toolkit. What? So now this is disappearing. I don't understand that. I don't know if you noticed that the menu is disappearing when hovering. Oh my god. And it's not responding. Okay, so what I will do, let me close and restart the application. Okay, now it's seen. As intended, layout. A manager. So let me get rid of mine. Browser, is that? Yeah, delete this. Classic. Warrior. Doesn't make a difference. Last used. I don't see difference between Warrior and Classic. So what I want is this, exactly this, but with knowledge tree here, instead of the statistics. But as soon as I click, it shows. Oh my god! Now it's working. Okay, window layout save, save custom layout. That is my default. Okay. Save as default. Layout, apply default, not save as default. My D. Okay, moving on. Not template. Oh, so you can use not template at all. Memory bias. So the console memory bias. Template. Item template this item. Topic template this article. So let me select article picture. Let's see. No template. Okay, how can I put a template on this? Apply. Okay. Nope. So how can I copy the picture here? I'm gonna move this. Fit the component. Okay. Copy. Doing. Oh, I'm copying. That can be done hard, bro. That's what is not working for me, the Control F8. Oops. What he did here? If he's not telling the shortcuts. Insert, localize. Yeah, I don't get what he did. Helpful. Just string articles. Let's try this one. Gotcha. So the 10% is actually the downloading. So I always have 0%. That means that the picture never downloads. Cool. He goes so quickly. Okay, did that there. Wow. No. Okay, components, tile arrangement, yeah, commander, fill pictures, something like that. Oh. So when you create topics or extracts from a topic, you can get only one of the pictures if you have more. That may be useful in the future. I haven't thought of this. Cool. So, I will try the control F8. I'm not downloading the full resolution, but that's okay. Okay. And it does nothing. F8. Insert. Yeah. Okay, so I know how to do it at least via F8. But they have a feature here. I could be able to transfer it as a component pretty quickly. Let me get that super memo add picture as component. Yeah, well, visual learning. I know I have this in my collection, but I want to very quickly see. So the only way to do is by F8. What if I want to use a picture in my hard disk? Quickly adding pictures. On the element you want to paste the picture to. Click yes to do one to it. The image register input box. Typed intuitive name. Okay, let me try this. Do we have more pictures? It's in the, let me see, yeah, it's in the registry, right? Yep. Cool. Okay, so I know how to at least move pictures that are in the very same article. Okay, so now let me try. That is Sandcast. I want this one. Copy image. Control V. Not just working. So in the tutorial they said that you can copy in the component you wanted. It's only working in this component, in the text, not the picture. If I select this, it's not working. Nope. Absolutely not working. Copy. Let me check if it's in the clipboard. Yeah. paste. No, it's absolutely doing nothing. Fantastic. Go to SuperMemo and press Ctrl-V on the element you want to paste the picture into. I want this one. The picture. This element. I want it here. Please. Paste. And it's doing nothing again. Cool. Absolutely nothing. Yes. Nope. Now it's not working in either side. That's not working at all. I'm using Ctrl-B. I have the prompt, and in the prompt I say yes. Let me check the registry. I think it's not there. What's the name? Close this. New image. Copy image. Sunk cost double VP. Sunk cost. Nope. Yes. And now it's like the screen doesn't respond. I have to press escape. Oh. Yes, please. For some reason, it's not working. I tried everything I could. It's not working via mouse, not via shortcut. And it's not working in any of the components. So the only thing that is working, it's F8. That's it. Nothing else is working. Hello. What? The video that is not working. Okay. Incremental video. Okay. Sorry. Okay, moving on, the sound cost, yeah. Event-based articles can be become taxing if we get all the support daily channels. If you're on TV, there's activities live and personally, Incremental learning is a perfect remedy for limited attention span. Even a single unlucky paragraph in an article may greatly reduce your enthusiasm for reading. If you stumble against a few frustrating paragraphs, you may gradually develop a dislike of reading a particular article. You may even become fed up with reading for the entire evening. Yeah. True story. Modality effect. Memory bias. References, extra links. Okay, the effect is a term used in experimental psychology, most often in the fields dealing with memory and learning. To refer how a learner performance depends on the presentation mode of studied items. Okay. The term used to refer to how the learner performance depends on the presentation mode of studied items. What? Do you want to apply a single template item? I don't want the extra space. Then shift. Okay. Why is telling me this now? Do you want to apply similar template item? I don't get this. Okay. Description. Echoic memory. Sounds okay. Who knows your lot? Okay. Multimedia learning. That's the same as e-learning. Well, zooming, slicing, framing, and cropping pictures. display only a small portion of a picture in a given element. Add zoom. What's the same you can do with the where it is? Well, with the menu, right? Okay, I will leave this to the feature. Isn't it true that incremental reading, you spend only a few seconds on this topic? I read this already. Yep. Familiarity heuristic, a mental shortcut applied to various situations in which individuals assume that the circumstances underlying the past behaviors still hold true for the present situation, and that is the past behavior, thus can be corrected applied to a new situation. Especially relevant when the individual's appearances is a high cognitive load. If you keep keeping the protection statistic, you may also realize that sending items beyond your average priority protection will help you clear them from view for a while. This way, you may have created too many close deletions that crowd your process. You may actually enjoy sending most of them out of the protected zone and focus on just one or two that capture the sense of knowledge you're trying to learn. Okay, so it's more like the boring functionality in Anki. So you may have some cards with close deletions, but you don't want to be shown today, so you bury them. And it's the same as being suspended, in this case dismissed, for a while, for a day. Okay. For topics, a factor modulate topic priority. Instead of next interval, it's the priority. Incremental learning manual interaction. So I'm guessing you have to use Outlook. I never used Outlook in my life. I use Thunderbird. Well, usually I use webmail, but if I had to choose a desktop client, I will use Thunderbird. That's what I did back in the day. Mail, sending learning data to others. That's where bent stuff like that. I won't read now. Newer super memos. SuperMemo versions, I guess, use a simple and fully automated mechanism that will help you combine high volumes of reading with high protection of the most important material. This mechanism is based on the concept of the priority queue. The creative process is unpredictable, and when you hit your best ideas is when the rest of the team is asleep. That's for incremental mail. Yeah. The example. Yeah, I can get rid of this one. Reference system highlights. article parent concept group. Is the concept group or still concept group? Oh yeah. Article link source date author title. So this is missing comment. Local edits may affect only the present element, and the global edits will change all elements that we are using the architecture as well. And SuperMemo is not sure if your edits are local or global, it will ask you. Unsearch SuperMemo works on text, not elements. You can only modify, set, merge, delete the reference across number of elements. Set reference, merge elements, and delete reference. Study material, non material, and final drawing. Auto postpone is enabled to that. Yeah. Important, do not add your own reference text below the horizontal bar, mark it to reference area. So you don't have to modify it like this. So what you need is to go to references and change it there. Okay. Okay. Incremental readings solve all major dilemmas of massive readers. Incremental readers are leaders. Yeah, I don't need that. Task manager. Incremental video on YouTube. I won't use YouTube for now. Select information. Insert. Cool. What? Oh, that's high resolution. Selection omission is a memory bias. In collective memory, it is a bias where a group, state, media, public opinion, works to forget traumatic memories. This expression is often used for possible or random history, more coherent way according to local stereotypes, and more moral values, which may include denying war atrocities. Stereotypes. Which stereotypes is a heuristic? When remembering things that one past years to remember events that are tied to a major life-changing event. That was just a tsunami. If that it was happening because the event thought they remembered the attacks, they have brought the direct fire on everybody. They conclude that people use historic events to date their memories. However, what events they use and how they choose to use them remains to be determined. So I know people, for instance, that for memorizing dates are using their relationships. So, oh, I was with this person back in the time, or with the other one, so I know it's at least 2010 or before. I wasn't with the other one, so it's earlier than 2015, so it's between this range, and they are narrowing down the range with the relationships they had in that time. Okay. So I want this research paper. Okay, well, I'll leave it here for now. Memory inhibition. And that's memory bias. Well, history imperfects. Interference memory, that's something with high priority for me. Come on. Oh, come on, twice. Delete. Why it's not deleting this? Nope, it's not deleting. Come on, bro. Delete after cursor. What was the option? Delete after cursor. What was the shortcut? control point. Okay, control point. Recognizing intuitable text. Pictures. That's what he did. Was me akin to that video I saw before. Instrumental writing. So he suggests to use a new collection for instrumental writing. So that is what I guess when Wozniak SuperMemo Guru pretty bad example. Why is not? In so many cases, you had here the references, as in SuperMemo style, right in the wiki. And my question is, how do you write this? That's HTML. It's not plain text. So how he one incremental writes with HTML. Okay, that's pretty high priority. Let me change the priority. Thank you. much mercy templates, so I have to use a different collection. Okay, let me try this. Open new collection. I will call it Anki and SuperMemo. Now here I create to do and another one. Note that the chat. I want this. I don't want this. Control Alt N. Yeah. Article. Open collection. Root the article range incrementally. Add triggers, citation links, etc. Are you to do this range incrementally? Okay, I will try this another day. This Sunday. Okay, task list manager menu. Next Sunday. Wow. Too much text. Incremental writing interaction. Yeah, that's all writing now. I will move on. And so I want to do the final drill. Man, what's the final drill? Wow, let me see the statistics. That's the session from today. Wow. So I spent 1 hour, 40 minutes, but I only have been repetitions for 2 minutes and a half. Wow. So the repetitions is just a very tiny fraction of the session. So I'm not used to this, because usually in Anki, I do mainly repetitions and I edit or create cards, but almost all the session, all the time of the session is reviewing. So that will be repetitions. My rotation is kind of low, 83%. Outstanding material. I have studying materials. Okay. let's see if I can do the final drill. Here it is, finally. Work is a mental shortcut that assesses everything. Heuristic. Stereotyping. Which is a form of heuristics. A factor stands for absolute factor. I don't want this. Live. It determines how much intervals increase the intelligent process. A factor, right? Yeah. Items are elements for active recall. The authentic material. Translation is the fastest tool to convert texts into items. I know this is an element in the knowledge tree. Tasks are elements representing two jobs. The concept-based network of links is called a... semantic learning. A concept map. Nana are general ideas used in semantic learning. Concepts. Items are elements for testing material. The rate of throws on HTML is F6, but I don't want this now. A concept is an element. Yep. If a note, it is not the beauty of clauses in your collection that counts, but the beauty of your knowledge. Your wisdom, yeah. For topics and tasks, a factor is interpreted. Okay. An item is a simple page element. If an anna is used in a container for other node, a node, elements may have the form of glossaries. Worth the third one. Glossaries. Oh my god. Items, topics, concepts, and tasks. Those are elements. Concepts are representing general ideas used in semantic. Oh. I see that I try to do this as a hint, and it's in the whole text. I see. Concepts are elements. Good. You can optimize the degree of na-na-na by using various tools. Monothematic focus. Okay. Where do they have the remaining count of the reviews after repetitions? I know how many are left to do. Is this one? Outstanding items. Okay, we'll do a couple more. It's both a skill and a habit. Incrementalism. Yep. Topics can be in the form of topics, not items. Topics is what I was trying. Yeah, summaries, extracts, and articles. the minimum time, effort, work. Yeah, it's the same. Stereotyping works as a shortcut, mental shortcut, to assess everything. A topic is an element that represents a page of knowledge, a synthetic overview. Failure. For items, factors reflect item difficulty. Yeah. Tasks in semantic learning. Compass maps form the skeleton for the spreading activation, which underlies knowledge base, neural review. Yeah. Concepts, the process of forgetting garbage collection, executing sleep, have to load precisely to prevent overloading memory, and the role of sleep. Knowledge store in in topics. Yep. For topic and task, a factor is known as a number of which. Yeah. Testing material, items. Item. Yeah, I can recall. Multiple topics and items, or even tasks, can be linked to a concept. Is that a finish? How many do I have left? So I have 70 items now that are not dismissed. Okay, I will have just one, this one, and that's it. Yeah. Okay, so for today I will leave the session here. What is? So today I learned the tasks, okay. And I don't understand concept groups or schedule and difference. Yeah, that's already tackled. Yeah, I need to fully understand the pictures, because I only can only do the picture thing via Control F8 and not with copy pasting. Okay. New. How to paste up an image as a component. Steps shown in the wiki do not work. I see the window prompt and that. Nothing happens and I do get the pip sound if I try to do anything. All I can do is spamming escape. Okay. And this means that, and that's another day. I think that's the 7 day. That will be a week. So let me see the entire time commitment. So that's from today, almost 2 hours. But I want to see the overall, not just today. The total time. What's that? That's the total time reviewing, doing repetitions, right? So I don't get the full time. Okay, well, screenshot this and ask SuperMemo community. Okay, so I will leave the session here. Thank you for watching, and I hope this may be useful at any point for anyone who's switching Anki to SuperMemo. See ya.